one left. In class 1 level, you can say this is the fixed point. So this is known as fulcrum. I'm just going to write down the word here. Load represent L. Effort represent E. And fulcrum represent F. So it is, it makes you more. It is fulcrum. One part we have kept the effort, on another part we have kept the load. This picture or this type of picture you might have observed in a garden.
Yes, ma'am.
What's the name of this type of swing?
The seesaw.
Seesaw. Very good. Seesaw is a type of class 1 level in which the fulcrum is at the middle point. And the object at the, or the child who is sitting at one point is known working as an effort. The child on the second point is working like a load. The one example, very good example of this type of tool is scissor. What is this?
Scissor.
So if I want to cut any paper, where I have kept the paper? As just like Sameer. Sameer want to keep the paper. So you have to keep the paper on the front page, just like in this way. So this paper is working like a load. And where I kept the effort, where I put the effort? On this part. So this is effort. And where I have observed the fulcrum? Middle part. So this is the class 1 level. This is load. This is effort. And the middle part is
fulcrum.
This is example of class 1 level. You can see the another one too. Have you ever seen this?
Yes, ma'am.
What is the name of this? Yes. Very good. Clap well. Kavish, have you ever done the electrician work? At your home? Basically, we have observed this tool with the electricians, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So this is a wire. Here also, the wire we have kept on the front part. So the load is kept on the one part, effort we have kept on the back side, and where is the fulcrum? Middle point. So this is the class 1 level. This is the example of a class 1 level. It is clear?
Yes,
ma'am. Now come to know about the second class level. position is going to be changed. The same, but now fulcrum is here, or you can see load is here, effort is here, and fulcrum is that point. Now, what is comes in between? Effort comes in between load and fulcrum. Little bit difference, now. Again, confusing. So I am taking this one. What is this?
Stepler.
Stepler. Very good. And if I want to use this, where I put the load? At the front. And where I kept the effort? Middle. And where is the fulcrum? Last one. Very good. And I am going to show you one very good example of it. What is this? This is a tong which we use to make chapati. This is also example of class 3 level. Chapati we put here, load, front, we put the effort at the middle point, and fulcrum is at the last point. So this is the example of class 3 level. Now I'm going to show you one video which helps you to understand more about labor.
Types of levers.
As I have told you, the
levers are simple machines that help to do heavy work with less effort. Levers have three factors: fulcrum, load, and effort. Based on the position of the factors, levers are divided into three types: first class, second class, and third class.
You can see here, in class 1 level, fulcrum is in between load and effort. In class 2 level, load is in between fulcrum and effort. And in class 3 level, effort is in between load and fulcrum.
Class. First class levers have fulcrum in between the weight or load and energy or effort. In a seesaw, on one end will be one person nearer to the ground. He will be the load. On the other end will be another person away from the ground. He will try to push down, meaning he is putting effort. In between the load and the effort, the rod of the seesaw will move on a pivot, which will be the fulcrum. A pair of scissors is also an example of a first class lever.
I told you about that.
Yes.
Second class levers have load in between the effort and fulcrum. In a wheelbarrow, the load will be in the center and effort on one end where you push it. On the other end will be the wheel, which is the fulcrum. Third class levers have effort in between the load and fulcrum. When we use a pair of tongs, we put the effort in the center. The load will be on one end and the fulcrum will be on the other end. Summary: levers are simple machines used to do heavy work with less effort. First class levers have fulcrum in the center. Second class levers have load in the center. Third class levers have effort in the center.
So kids, when you know about this thinking, I'm going to tell you acronym. Do you know what is the meaning of acronym? Acronym is a word in which we are taking the first word of any sentence and make it very easier to learn. It is quite difficult for you to learn where is the fulcrum in first class level, where is the load in the second class level. So make it more easy and just class 2 level L stands for
load.
And in class 2 level load is in the middle point. Okay? And what is the meaning of E? And in class 3 level E stands in the middle point. So in this way you can learn the all class 3 levels in a very simple way. Just recite it.
Three.
It is?
Three.
That helps you to learn more about the levels. Now,